Meeting all dignitaries, welcome you all to the inaugural session of the fifth edition of International Tooling Summit. I invite Mr. DK Sharma, President Tagma India, for his welcome address. Thank you.
Honorable Minister for Road Transport and Highways and SME, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, distinguished scientist and Director General of Missiles and Strategic Systems, DRDO, Shri MSR Prasad ji, prominent industry leaders, our valued customers, eminent speakers at the summit, our partners from India and abroad who are online now, and my fellow members of TAGMA. I heartily welcome you all to the fifth edition of our flagship event, International Tooling Summit, the first virtual one. I am feeling so proud today as a representative of the toolmaker fraternity, 95% of who fall under MSME category. The tooling industry is often referred to as the mother industry because tools, dies and molds are the building blocks for the manufacturing industries, without which the dream of building world-class products would be far from fulfilled. My fellow toolmakers have made tremendous contributions and have made good progress over the last few years and have created new benchmarks despite many constraints. However, I must highlight here that all the manufacturing hubs across the globe boast of an equally strong tooling industry, with India being an exception. Unfortunately, there are several issues constraining our growth. If they are removed, sir, we are all set to encash the opportunities made available by government's big initiatives of Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat. Mantri ji, we are a skill, knowledge and capital intensive business. This pandemic has taught us many things. Going digital is no more an option, but a compulsion. For a long time, Industry 4.0 and smart manufacturing has been widely talked about, but now it's time to make it a reality. We must adopt futuristic technologies and to be able to compete globally. TAGMA has created various platforms to bring all stakeholders together under one roof to deliberate our issues and find best solutions by learning from each other. Having said that, there are certain issues which are beyond our control. I would like to appeal to our customers over here, mainly OEMs and tier ones, want to trust us more and throw us newer challenges rather than importing tools from China and other countries. We are aware that there are several problems faced by the users due to lack of after-sale service from overseas tool suppliers. I would also urge them to specify domestically developed elements of the tool and other hardwares rather than insisting on the imported brands. Some of the foreign brands have put up their shop here in India. I am aware of, they are in Chakan and in South. They make equally good quality, hardware which should be used. As I mentioned earlier, since 95% of the tool makers fall under MSME category, the biggest support today we are looking for from our customers is to revisit the payment modalities and make them more tool room friendly. Current delays in releasing of milestone payments, fair and time-bound settlement of claims for emerging engineering changes, this will definitely help the tool makers manage the cash flow. Majority of our tool makers are finding difficult to mobilize working capital and funds to grow the business. Coming to the policy related issues, sir, we are pleased to see that a lot of initiatives being rolled out by Government of India, which will boost. However, policy support is needed on various fronts in order to ensure cost competitiveness in the face of competition from imported dyes and molds. Inverted duty structure and duty-free imports make it very difficult for us, sir, as domestic tool makers to compete on an even footing. For instance, import duty on standalone items like tool steel, mold bases and other items is higher than that duty on the import of finished goods, finished molds, I mean. Sir, we strongly recommend increase of import duties on the molds procured from China and other countries, which will help promote the local industry. Like in most leading tool manufacturing countries, the Indian tool makers would also be willing to expand their capacities if government brings reforms to develop tooling clusters like in Taiwan and China and Korea to make our operations more efficient and faster. I would like to assure you, sir, if these bottlenecks and policy issues are addressed, we are all set to support all the manufacturing sectors, including defense, railways, metro coaches, aerospace, besides serving the needs of dominant automobile segment that we currently serve. Honorable Minister, we are quite motivated by your presence today here with us and hope to turn around our tooling industry also the way you are making it happen in the building of roads and highways under your leadership. Thanking you. During the next 2 days in the summit. Thank you. May I now invite distinguished scientist and Director General MSS, Shri M.S.R. Prasad, address.
Very good morning, sir. Honorable Union Minister, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, Shri D.K. Sharma, President Agma India, all the invited guests and participants to this International Tooling Summit, a very good morning to all of you. I am very happy to be a part of this inaugural session today on behalf of Dr. Satish Reddy, Chairman DRDO. The tooling and the gauging industry is a capital intensive, skill and knowledge based industry, supported by innovation and playing a vital role in manufacturing. Almost every manufacturing company requires tooling and gauges to perform the production process and assembly of parts produced. Therefore, the tooling industry is the backbone of the manufacturing industry to provide products of high quality in a cost-effective manner at a reasonably high speed. The ever-increasing demand for automobiles, domestic appliances and consumer electronics will ensure an expanding need and demand for the dyes, molds, tools and gauges. The defense sector in our country is also expanding very fast with production of DRDO developed products alone crossing 5 crores till date, and it is growing continuously. We expect this production of DRDO products to touch at least another 2 lakh crores more in the next 2 to 3 years. More than 5,000 MSMEs are participating in this product production activity, and extensive tooling is used in the manufacture, inspection and assembly of these products. All these products are made by PSU or senior private. I would just give an example, like the wheel aspect gun production, which L&T is involved. It involved more than 500 MSMEs, even though they are doing the manufacturing and other things. So in similar way, the Akash missile that has gone into production, which was developed at a cost of 600 crores. Today the production order is more than 40,000 crores. And nearly 800 MSMEs are involved in making the various products, components, and giving it to BDL, who are doing the final integration and testing, which means almost 95% of the production cost is realized through the MSMEs. So a lot of tooling is required to be made to meet this production schedule. Unlike in the automobile and the consumer product, the tooling in aerospace gives a thrust for stringent quality standards and reliability in product realization, which calls for advanced and precision tooling development. In aerospace, particularly distortion control and stringent form tolerances form an important aspect of aerospace manufacturing. So this calls for very specialized tooling, which needs a lot of design innovation. DRDO has taken up development of a number of missile projects, and many are in the advanced stage of testing and user evaluation. You must have been seeing that in the last 2 months we have tested more than 12 to 15 types of products, and they are all in the various stages of development. Many of them have reached the user interface trials also. So it is expected that in the next few years, most of these designs will be cleared for production. Extensive tooling will be required to meet this production, covering the sheet metal forming, castings of various sizes and materials, die forging, precision manufacturing, ceramics and composites products, rubber and plastic molded products, welding, and heat treatment of specialized materials and components, inspection and assembly. So manufacturing and ceramics and composites is highly process intensive, which requires extensive tooling. With the Government of India initiative of Make in India, about 101 defense products have been identified, and these cannot be imported in future. So all these products will have to be made in the Indian industry, which is now even open to the private sector. Apart from this, DRDO has identified about 108 products which can be taken up with the Indian industry on a built specification. So the industry in India has matured, which had moved from build to print into build to specification, and DRDO is ready to hold hands of the industry partners to see that the products are successfully developed through the industry. Industry corridors for defense, private sector participation in defense development and production, liberal policies to boost defense exports, 100% FDA in defense industry will be a boost to this tooling industry. Self-sufficiency in the area of missiles, torpedoes, tanks, artillery guns, radars, and bridging systems through DRDO will pave way for production of these items. It is therefore necessary for the tooling industry to innovate, develop advanced tooling of high quality, adopting advanced technologies. Adaptive additive manufacturing for tool development and use of AI in tool design can be considered. Cost improvement through value engineering and proper tool selection and utilization will be beneficial for international competition. Automation in tooling will also be an added advantage. Use of advanced tooling in production can reduce the need for costly CNC machines and highly skilled labor, thereby giving cost and time benefits. Product innovation, technology development of the whole manufacturing system strongly depends on innovation and developments in tooling. Tools, dies and molds manufacturing industry has substantially multiplier effect on the domestic economy. Therefore, it must be nurtured to become self-reliant. I hope this International Tooling Summit being organized by DAGMA India will be highly beneficial to the Indian industry and the tooling industry in particular. My best wishes for the success of this tooling summit. Thank you and Jai Hind.
We will now play profile of Shri Nitin Gadkari ji.
There are followers, there are leaders, and then there are visionaries. Taking people and society to where they ought to be rather than where they want to be is what separates a visionary from a mere leader. This rare quality is what sets apart Nitin Gadkari, Honorable Minister of Road Transport and Highways and Minister of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, from many of his ilk. With his indefatigable positive energy and a deep desire to use politics as a catalyst to serve society, Nitin Gadkari continues to impress all with his sterling performance over the years. Born in 1957 into a free-thinking agricultural family, Nitin Gadkari at heart has always been a social worker inspired by the RSS founder K.B. Hedgewar's ideals of humanity and nation-building. Nitin Gadkari has been shouldered with immense responsibility by the party from an early age. He was only in his 30s when he took over as PWD minister in the BJP government of Maharashtra during 1995 and 1999. His stupendous performance has been thoroughly appreciated by the BJP, who went on to make him their youngest ever party president at the age of 52. Since then, he has gone on to become one of the best performing ministers of the BJP government. Taking off as a minister of the Public Works Department in 1995, Nitin Gadkari made groundbreaking changes in the speed the city of Mumbai traveled. 55 flyovers dotting the city have made commuting in Mumbai much easier than ever before. The foundation of the magnificent Bandra Worli Sea Link was also readied during this time. The jewel of the crown of Maharashtra, India's first expressway, the world-class Pune-Mumbai Expressway, is also a futuristic project imagined and brought to fruition by Nitin Gadkari. Connecting over 13,000 unconnected villages with an all-weather $100 million project is another feat accomplished by this far-sighted visionary. Nagpur, his hometown, has seen world-class institutions like IIT, IIM and AIIMS emerge and thrive under his watchful gaze. This is in addition to the over 1,000 Ekal Vidyalayas that go a long way in molding the future tribal generations, providing financial support for performing over 10,000 successful heart surgeries is another stupendous achievement in his illustrious career as a warm-hearted do-gooder. Cemented roads and metro rail have added a new vitality to the way people travel in the city. Festivals like Khasdar Sanskritik Mahotsav, with a reach of more than 10 lakh people over 17 days of festivities to promote the local as well as national artists at a huge platform, have been organized. Krida Mahotsav, a sports festival with participation about 10,000 sports persons, where Nitin Gadkari shared his dream of the Nagpur youth representing at the Olympics. Farmer-friendly projects like AgroVision, along with his idea of using sewage water for power generation, use of ethanol as fuel. As India's current Minister of Road Transport Highways, Shipping and MSMEs, he has re-energized the whole sector with his clear vision. Be it reviving stalled projects of over $1 trillion or doubling the speed of highway construction, his lofty targets have always been achieved well before the projected timelines. With 40,000 kilometers of national highways constructed in the last 5 years, 60,000 kilometers of new roads under his supervision are being constructed. The speed of road construction from a mere 3 kilometers per day before 2014 has grown to 29 kilometers per day in 2019. Bharatmala and Sagarmala, two world-class access-controlled expressway projects led by Nitin Gadkari, are presently in various stages of construction. Exploring alternate modes of transportation like waterways mirrors the speedy and revolutionary transformation of the Indian landscape initiated by the bridge-building messiah, as he is fondly referred to. Nitin Gadkari is the leading hand in shaping the dream of a new India as envisaged by Narendra Modi. His unparalleled ability to complete gigantic projects before time makes him an invaluable national leader. The larger-than-life Namami Ganga project top priority national mission, Clean Ganga, is also progressing at top speed under his keen-eyed supervision. With Nitin Gadkari taking charge, India's most maligned logistics sector has also metamorphosed from a point-to-point model to a hub-and-spoke model. This multimodal transport system integrates railways, highways, inland waterways and airports, conjuring a highly effective transportation grid, substantially reducing logistic costs and pollution. 35 multimodal logistics parks, 50 economic corridors, 10 intermodal stations are being readied, logistics summits with international participants including government organizations and the World Bank, leading to MOUs worth 2 lakh crore, have been held to add muscle to the initiative. Gifted with an ability to dream the seemingly impossible dreams and getting them to fruition also defines this clairvoyant visionary. Nitin Gadkari shines on as one of modern India's pioneering leaders and his work a template for the coming generations. If there ever was a name to the infrastructure man of India, it would be none other than Nitin Jairam Gadkari.
सर एक बार फिर से मैं आपका अभिवादन करता हूं और ये हमारा सौभाग्य है कि आज आप हमारे साथ हैं। अभी मेरे छोटे बड़े सभी टूल मेकर साथी करीब 700 लोग इंडिया में जुड़े हुए हैं साथ में अभी, और बाहर से भी आपके चहेते, आपके प्रशंसक और हमारे टूल मेकर जो हमारे को मदद करने के लिए तैयार हैं वो भी आपको सुनने के लिए आतुर हैं। सर मैं एक बात बताना चाहूंगा कि टैगमा पीरियोडिकली सर्वेस कंडक्ट कराता है इंडस्ट्री के लिए, और हमारी ऐसी एक सर्वे बुक रिपोर्ट आज हमारे लिए रेडी है। मैं आपसे निवेदन करूंगा कि उसे आप रिलीज करें, हम लोगों का सौभाग्य है ये। धन्यवाद। गाइडेंस
के प्रेसिडेंट डीके शर्मा, हमारे डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डिफेंस रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट के सेक्रेटरी और चेयरमैन DRDO डॉक्टर जी सतीश रेड्डी, ऑल रिस्पेक्टेबल डियर फ्रेंड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गिविंग माय स्पेशल थैंक्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट यू हैव गिवन मी अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टूलिंग इन इंडिया. Actually, the Atmanirbhar Bharat, which is the mission of our Prime Minister, where we need to increase more production, good quality, and delivery on time and punctuality, 100% we need 101% perfection. I know that when I got appointed to visit Germany, I always impressed by the progress of Germany. That is the one of the most important reasons. The tooling centers in Germany, they done an excellent job in the development, in the industrial development of Germany. And that is the reason that the German products has got a special reputation in the whole world. The basic objective of the tool room is to make mass production. Without mass production, we cannot be able to. And mass production with the good quality is the innovation, entrepreneurship, science, technology, research, skill, and successful practices. We name it as a knowledge and conversion of knowledge into future production. And that is one of the reason that actually in for recruiting or export in industrial sector, we need to make more research, we need to accept more successful technologies. For that reason, we need to tool room. That is very important thing that we can do. And for the Atmanirbhar, this is very, very, very important. The millions of items, parts are manufactured again and again using the tools. which are molds, dies, jigs, fixers and gauges. The machine tool industry is the backbone of Indian economy, and it is the mother industry of the capital goods sector. It determines the share of manufacturing in GDP of any country. Presently in our GDP, our 14 to 16% GDP is coming from the agriculture and allied industries, which is agro-based industries. 22 to 24% from manufacturing sector and 52 to 56% from service sector. Actually, for making India as an Atmanirbhar Bharat, we need to increase the growth rate where we at least we have a target to get 30% of GDP contribution from agriculture and at least 40% from the manufacturing sector. Manufacturing sector is very important. It is going to create more employment potential in the country. It is going to create more exports, and that is very important for the country. So 100% that manufacturing sector is depending upon the innovation, designs, research, and for that reason, we need to develop tool rooms in India. The tool rooms blends hardware, software, and manpower to design and develop tools of highest quality and efficiency is very important. The concept requirement is design, tooling, and manufacturing. This is a three-tier system by which we can achieve our goal. The present key number of tool rooms in the sector, the global production of machine tools is worth around $84 billion. China's contribution is $34 billion and India's consumption is $3 billion, that is rupees 20,000 crore. The local production is $1.5 billion, imports are $2 billion and exports are only $0.5 billion. This is not a good thing for the country. We need to change the things. And I'm very much confident about that it is not only with the government we can do it. It is the time for to make a joint venture between government and private sector and to encourage private sector for making tool rooms and making more research and designs. And for that reason, we need to encourage our talent. India is a country where we have maximum young, talented engineering manpower is available. We have got all type of raw materials available. Our labor cost is very cheap. If suppose we plan with appropriate vision for the future, I am confident that our tool rooms 100% will change the total scenario of the country. This is the heart of our progress, heart of our manufacturing sector. But presently, I am not satisfied what the things are doing. We are doing and you are moving. Actually, MSME tool rooms, we have 18 numbers, contributes only rupees 80 crores. The performance is beyond expectation. And it's very, very, I don't make any more comments on it. It is worst as far as the performance of these tool rooms, which are already run by the government, particularly Department of MSME. We are seriously thinking, in the government, we need ownership, initiative, transparency, time-bound decision-making process, and collective team spirit, and appropriate vision for the future. And that is very important. Now we are thinking to how we can make it our tool rooms more effective. For that reason, we are now planning to involve industries, successful industries, IITs, engineering colleges, and industries association. And even the private people who are doing excellent job in the tooling sectors, where we are also want to make joint venture with them. And our infrastructure can be used and we will get more productivity. Our MSME tool room focus has shifted to only for training. Training is important, but the training, that is not the purpose, only purpose for the tool rooms. we need more research. Designing of new products is equally important. However, this should be the secondary objective as far as the training is concerned. The core objective should be development of tools to promote local manufacturing industry in that area. Some of the area where the people are making different type of shoes, some of the area which are involved with the automobile sectors, some of the area where the casting is the main industry. Different type of clusters are there in the different part of the area of the states, districts and regions. As far as the what are the industries which are there, what are the development in that area, what are the skilled manpower which is available, on the basis of that we have to plan our tool room for as a facilitator, as a supporter for the industry. We need out of box ideas to utilize this huge infrastructure of 18 well-established tool rooms to make them more efficient and help local manufacturing industry under Atmanirbhar Bharat program. In due course of time, we are going to plan a policy for that. For that reason, we need cooperation from the private sector and particularly the successful people who are doing, who have success story in their tool rooms. India has approximately 1,000 tool rooms. 25 big tool rooms are contributing 75% of the business. This is very important. I'm giving my special thanks to them. But I am requesting them. These 25% big tool rooms, if they are ready to use the infrastructure of our 18 tool rooms, we can think on the line to make a joint venture with them where they can use our infrastructure. They can make more profits. And also their contribution will be at least present situation, it will be 10 times more. So this is the very important, I always talking to the people that financial audit is very important. But financial audit is important at the most, there are more important thing is performance audit. Performance audit is more important than financial audit. And that is very important. For that reason, we need ownership. Without ownership, we cannot make miracles. This is our country. We have to fulfill the dream of Prime Minister Modi ji to make India a global economy in the world. And for that reason, we have to make all type of changes, reforms in the concerning sectors. As for the manufacturing sector, it's time for the country that we should think in that line. Existing 18 tool rooms centers in MSMEs. In 2014-15, new technology centers at a cost of rupees 2,200 crore were approved. In 2018, 20 new tooling centers and 100 extension centers with a total investment of 6,000 crore were approved. But here we need the cooperation from the 25 big tool rooms who are contributing 75% of the business. We are open to make a joint venture with them. I already discussed all this thing with our all concerning officers. Presently, it's a very good thing for me. One of the talented IIT graduate, Mr. Amol Mirazdar, who is here, who is helping me, contributing me, and giving me the reports on a grassroots level. He's a very intelligent man. He has actually have a very, very good service, getting good salary, but he resigned. He want to work for the country, for the nation, for the reason he coming with me. And with his cooperation, we are now framing the policy. My suggestion to all of you that you should maintain your good contact with Amol Birajdar. He will be my representative and give him all suggestions. He will making the policy and giving me the recommendations. On the basis of that, 100%, we are going to make transformation in the sector. As for the sources of tooling requirement, 48% by commercial tool rooms for smaller companies, 27% by captive tool rooms, big companies, and 25% by import. About TAGMA, also I'm very much positive. And I feel that your role is very important. I expect you to take more initiative using of government infrastructure, using of make coordination. There we need cooperation, coordination, and communication. To create awareness in the mind of the stakeholders is equally important. all of the big industries and major industries, the corporate people, I request them, at least 2% of the profit, you should invest in the research, tool rooms, technical research, innovations. That is very important. The skilled manpower, the trained manpower, the research in the products, we don't want to compromise with the quality, but we need to reduce the cost and make a good quality of international standard. Now I am as a transport minister, I have a dream that within 5 years, we will make India is a number one manufacturing hub for automobile industry. We are making electric cars, bikes, buses, even for trucks. 2 days before I inaugurated the JCB running on bio-CNG. We are now planning to make up bio-CNG, electricity, ethanol, methanol, biodiesel, and hydrogen fuel cell as a fuel. So these are the options with the huge potential is available in automobile industry. Huge potential is available in energy and power sector. Huge potential is available in the agriculture. And huge potential is available in the defense sector. Already our secretary is present. Now government has taken a lot of decision. Defense sector is a sector where we need, we can change the total scenario and we can become a leader in the defense sector. For that reason, we need to make our system, our management, our administration on fast track, taking decision fast, taking decision with transparency and giving support to the industry. And this is the time that we need to change our approach and vision for that. The defense sector can create huge employment potential in the country. I remember Dr. Abdul Kalam Saab was every time telling to the people that we need to manufacture helicopters in India. I don't know. I don't want to elaborate the thing. But still we are not in a position to manufacture good quality helicopters. We have a requirement of amphibious seaplane. At least 10,000 seaplane we can use, and there we already the water bodies, inland waterways, the sea, everything is available. It's not a big technology, but we don't have seaplane, amphibious seaplane. Now the drone we are developing. Even in the defense sector, there's a huge potential is available. We can make not only imports of essential defense goods, but we can make the export of it. I will give my special thanks to the Secretary of Defense and DRDO. That this is the time that we should open the sector. We give opportunity to Indian MSME. We should encourage them, by which 100% I am confident that we will change the scenario. I know that in Cochin Shipyard, I encourage them. Today, the Cochin Shipyard is a flagship company of Bharat Sarkar. Now we have got a lot of shipyards. I many time convinced to Defense Ministry, if next 6 years, whatever the ships you require, if you can plan and give them order, nothing like that, but it will never happen. Now all private shipyards are closed. The economic viability is not good. That is the time that a company like L&T, those who invest in it, still they are facing losses. So this is the time with the transparent and time-bound approach is very important. I am very sorry to say, the people who are getting salary at every month at first, they never understand delay, what is the cost which you have to pay for that. And delays in decision is basically a big problem in the system. Everywhere we need to make a fast track decision making process, full transparency and corruption free system, quality consciousness, don't compromise with the quality. At the same time, we have to deliver the things. We have to make India a number one global economy in the world. And as a stakeholder, your role is very important. I will request Mr. Sharmaji, chairman of this institution, that your role is like a heart. But I am very frankly and fairly, I am telling to you, as a private sector and as a government sector, it is not up to the mark. I am not happy about it. If you want to give the marks out of 100, it is very difficult for me to give you marks more than 33. So this is not a good thing for India. Our comparison with China, our comparison with Germany, our comparison with South Korea, our comparison with USA, this is the time that of the international standards and parameter on the basis of that. We as a stakeholder, I am as a minister of MSME and my department is the most important department for that reason. And people like you, the defense ministry, all the stakeholders, the corporate, major industries, MSME industries, we have to accelerate this process by which we need to achieve our goal. I am very much confident that the goal of Atmanirbhar Bharat, 100% we need your cooperation. For that reason, we need to move fast. And that is only my request from my heart to all of you. I am really happy about this International Tooling Summit. I am giving my all best wishes to all of you. And I will support you. We will all encourage you. For any problem, whenever any suggestion, already our Atul is there, Birajdar. But same time, anytime you come to me, meet me, we will resolve the problem and we will accelerate the speed of our progress. And that is the need of the hour. I know that we are facing the problem because of COVID-19. In the economy also, we are facing the problem. But does positiveness and self-confidence on the basis of that, with our sincere efforts, by taking ownership, 100% we are going to achieve this goal of Atmanirbhar Bharat, and we will make India as a number one global economy in the world, and which is the dream of our Honorable Prime Minister. I am 100% confident that your cooperation and the cooperation from all the stakeholders, we will achieve this goal. I am giving my all best wishes to all of you, and 100% with the cooperation of all of you, 100% the next time when we will meet, the scenario will change and we will achieve our goal. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Yes. Thank you, sir, for your comprehensive guidance and promise of the support. Actually, we are quite happy. It has come directly from you that you are always available for the support. I think your visibility makes a lot of sense to us, sir. Today, when I talk to my tool makers, I think they will be jubilant about your promises. I assure you, sir, you have also assessed us and given us some marks, but you have also mentioned that you will support this industry. There are hurdles which are not in our hands. I am sure I will work very closely with Amol. And I, a couple of days back, sir, I interacted with all the 18 heads of the tool rooms. There was a lot of opportunity I saw. They have done some exemplary work. And India, some of the tool makers like us, we have made the parts for Chandrayaan, for ISRO. Abdul Kalam Saab used to come and encourage us very many times when we failed but bounced back under his vision and hand-holding. So today we have also made very, very challenging parts. You talked about German tool room, sir. I was there with Pradhan Mantri Ji in Make in India Fair in Stuttgart in the year 2014. Now, we took up a challenge and Indian tool makers have supplied even to Mercedes, the tools. Germans never buy tools from outside. So, but I hope you are aware that the steel of which all the tools are made is not made in the country. 99% is imported. And if we buy that steel, ministry that please, start making that tool steel in India, but it will take time. But my humble request is, if 10,000 crores, all of us, to make these intricate tools, we need to remove that BIS certification which has been imposed. So I will work with the officers and I will very closely put up our request, and I promise you, sir, the faith what you have shown us, we will not let you down. I think the time has come to keep targets. We are 12th in the global tool room industry. However, when the manufacturing of $1 trillion US is going to be achieved, we need to bounce back and come up to third or fourth level. I think that is the what the target we should set along with the government MSME tool rooms. I am very confident today, sir. The kind of assurance what you have given, from today onwards, I will be working very, very closely with all the officers to make your targets happen. And I'll come back to you along, inviting you in the next summit to report the progress to you, sir. That's my promise. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your presence and guidance and support.
I will now invite Mr. D. Shanmugasundaram for vote of thanks.
Good morning to everyone. I wish to communicate my utmost regard, admiration and respect as well as gratitude towards you for blessing us with your presence on our first ever virtual International Tooling Summit. Your words of encouragement are very much welcome, and we feel that our future is in safe hands. You have clearly given us the core objectives. Now it's upon us tool makers to focus on our core business and help our government in realizing the dream of Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India. I would like to extend my thanks to our chief guest, Sri Nitin Gadkari ji, Union Minister of MSME and Minister of Road, Transport and Highways. Sir, it is immense pleasure for us that you joined our event and bestowed us with your blessings. And you have also clearly rated us and given us directions. We are glad to host you, and your kind words and insights that facilitate change and growth, which is worth a lot to us. I also thank Dr. G. Satish Reddy, Secretary Department of Defense R&D and Chairman DRDO, for his keynote address. I thank all eminent speakers as well as guests who have joined this virtual summit from India and around the world. The event could not have been possible without the support from all of you. I am profoundly grateful to all the sponsors. We could successfully organize the summit owing to support of our sponsors in various categories. I also thank TAGMA management and secretariat, and a special thanks to our president DK Sharma, who have worked tirelessly since long time to make this summit a grand success. Once again, thank you all for making this magnificent virtual summit possible today. Let's enjoy the event today and tomorrow and interact, and let's achieve the goal and get good progress in the coming days. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Amol. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Amol.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you.